Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about most important personal interview questions which will be asked by the HR. Okay, let's begin our video. The first question when you enter into the HR round will be asked is introduce about yourself. HR can also ask this question in the different manner. It can be please run me through your resume or please run me through your CV. Okay, this means same as introducing about yourself. So most of the students for this question, they'll be answering all the irrelevant topics, such as they'll be telling their name, they'll be telling their family name, family details, siblings and their details. No, that is not the purpose here. You are asked just to introduce about yourself. Okay, so the first tip which I would like to give is you just need to understand the question which is asked by the HR properly. Okay, just try to listen and understand the question and then start answering. Okay, so you are asked just to introduce about yourself. What you need to mention as answer for this question is you need to tell your name, you need to tell your hobbies, you need to tell your positives, negatives, and you need to tell your educational qualifications. If you have any extracurricular activities, you can mention those. And if you have any hidden skills or talents or goals, passions, anything like that, which is relevant to the job, then only mention that. Okay, don't mention drawing, singing, all this. Okay, these are fine, these are your hobbies, well and good, but the thing is you should think from the company point of view. If you sing or if you dance or if you draw something, what is the use for the company? You are there not to show your talents, you are there to get a job, to sell yourself. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to mention all the positives, negatives, hobbies, all those things which is relevant or helpful to the job or relevant and helpful to the company. Okay, so try to prepare your answers accordingly to the need of the company. Okay, so just try to example, I'll just give you an example. Let me take my positives. Okay, as positives, I would like to mention I'm a hard worker. Okay, if you are a hard worker, it will help the company. In the negative, what will I mention is I'll mention I will not give up anything easily, so easily. That is my weakness. Okay, or that is my negative. See, listen, I said as negative, what I said as a negative, I will not give up anything or any task very easily. I'll keep trying till the last moment. Okay, so that is my negative. I mentioned that as my negative. But coming to the company point of view, if it has an employee who will never give up so easily, who will try to work hard till the last moment of the success, it will be really helpful to the company. Okay, so you need to mention those kind of positives and negatives or hobbies, whatever it might be, which will be really useful to the company. Okay, so plan accordingly. Okay, next, second question, second most important common question which will be asked by the HR is how about yourself or how about your family background. Okay, yourself is already done. Now here comes the question about the family background. Here you need to mention about your family. How many members are there in your family? What are their names? What do they do? What are their occupation or, you know, studies, whatnot? All the things here you can mention. Okay, and coming to yourself, you're going to tell only about yourself. Okay, now this third question is very important question. Why did you choose this particular course? Okay, this particular course means it might be BTech, BCom, BA, MBA, BBA, whatnot. Like it may be anything, BSc, anything. Okay, so they are trying to ask this question with a particular reason. Why did you choose this course? HR wanted to know whether you choose this course by chance or by choice. Okay, do you have well plan, or you just randomly chose that course? HR wants to know. That's why he's putting this question to you. What you need to answer for this question is, first, if I take BTech as example, what I need to answer is, first I'll tell why am I passionate about BTech? What knowledge have I gained with the help of BTech subjects? And what inspired me to take BTech? Okay, these 3 points I'll mention as this particular answer. Okay, next question. Why did you choose our company? Okay, so there are thousands and thousands of companies, and the HR wants to know why did you choose his particular company with a particular reason. Okay, so any company would like to recruit an employee who will show the long-term relationship. Okay, no company wants to recruit a person for 1 month or 1 year. It always wants the employee to show the long-term relationship with the company. Okay, so you should tell as an answer of this question, like, why did you choose our company for this particular question? This particular question is very important, and it will be deciding your future. Okay, trust me, this will decide your future. Okay, by this answer only, the HR will decide whether you are really interested about the company or you are sitting in front of him just for time pass. Okay, it will really matter your answer for this question. Okay, why did you choose this company? What you need to do is, you need to mention points about the company. Okay, it is one of the topmost company, topmost MNC, and you should mention its turnover, like it is running through profits, and what are its new products. All this you should try to know before going to HR round. Okay, and for this question you need to mention it is one of the topmost company. It will really give you a chance. Like, if I am answering this particular question, I'll say, sir, your company is one of the topmost company which will treat all the employees equally, and as a fresher I would really like to start my career with a one of the reputed company like yours, and your company will definitely help me to improve my knowledge, and I would like to prove myself in your company by attending all the challenges and by facing all the challenges with my hard work, and I'll put all the maximum effort to succeed with the task given to me. All those sort of question answers you need to give for this question. Okay, now let's see. They'll be asking next question as favorite subjects. Okay, now you need to mention all real favorite subjects. What all you have as a real favorite subjects you need to mention, because sometimes what they do is, the subjects which you mention as your favorite, they'll be asking reason, like why is that your favorite subject, and sometimes they'll be even asking questions from that subject. Okay, so give a genuine answer for this question. Okay, next, tell me about your hobbies. As I already said you before, you should mention your hobbies which will be related to the company. Okay, hobbies are for example, I will tell my hobby as learning new things is my hobby. Okay, think from company's point of view. If the employee is learning constantly or continuously and exploring his knowledge or her knowledge, then that will be really a great advantage to the company's growth. Okay, so those sort of hobbies you need to mention. Okay, next, tell me about your projects. Okay, in final year you will be doing major project, and in the previous semesters you'll be doing the mini project. All these projects you need to once again revise, because this is one of the excuse me, this is one of the most common question asked by every HR. That's why. Okay, and next question is, what are your strengths and weakness? Okay, your strengths and weakness should be chosen very very, very carefully. Coming to strength, you can tell you are having a positive attitude. That is your strength. You are hardworking, you're dedicated, you're a quick learner, all those things, okay, as a strength. And coming to weakness, you need to tell your weakness, which will turn into positivity or a strength of the company. Example, if I say that I would like to never give up my task till the last moment, that is my weakness. But for the company, if its employee is not ready to give up anything so easily, it will be an asset for the company, okay? So choose weakness and strength very, very, very carefully, okay? And if you have really bad weakness, just don't try to mention it, and always tell that you are trying to overcome your weakness, okay? And what is the toughest situation in your life and how did you deal with it? Okay, just try to remember some toughest challenging situation in your life, because this question will be asked to test your problem solving skills, okay? And your thinking ability, all those things, they'll decide for this answer, okay? Whatever answer you give for this, that will really matter, okay? Next, how will you deal with the angry boss or an angry client? Because coming to a company, it will have a lot more clients and a lot more employees or boss, whatever it might be. So it's common that there will be issues, angerness, irritation and frustration, all that. So they would like to know whether you are able to cope up yourself with the angry clients or angry boss, okay? And how will you handle the situation? You need to answer it like, for example, angry boss. For example, let us take the angry boss. I'll answer in this way. First, I'll know the reason why is he angry. Next, I'll try to rectify my mistake. If it is really my mistake, if it is not my mistake, I'll try to explain the boss the reason why I did that, or I'll try to explain him the situation and I'll try to clarify that it's not my fault, okay? It's not my error, what might be, okay? And I'll try to maintain a calm situation condition by pleasing him to be normal, like that, okay? You should generally give pleasing answers, not like I'll be arrogant, I'll shout at him, all those things will not work in HR. You should always think and answer, okay? Next, why should we hire you? You should tell all your advantages here, like I'm a quick learner, I'm having a skills which will be useful for your company projects, company's growth and all those sort of things, okay? And next, where do you want to see yourself in 5 years? Okay, so coming to this question, this particular question, they'll be asking to know whether you are really interested in the company or you are there for just passing your time, okay? So here you need to tell that you should not mention that I want to be a CEO in 5 years or I want to be president of India in 5 years. No, those sort of silly answers you should never give. You should give answers like I want to be a reliable senior who guides his juniors a correct path, okay? Those sort of answers you should give. And what is your dream job? Okay, you should mention your dream job. And what if we reject you? Okay, this is a negative question, but they will be asking you in order to observe your response, okay? So they'll ask, what if we reject you? Okay, you should say, sir, if you reject me, please let me know the reason why I am rejected so that mistake which I've done in this interview will not be repeated in the coming future. I'll try to improve myself. Okay, those sort of answers you should give for this question. That's it for today. Thank you so much, friends, for watching this video. Thank you so much for spending your time with Best Way to Study. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. And share this video with all your friends and colleagues. Thank Thank you so much. Bye bye. All the very best for your interviews.